My guest today is liberty activist Lily Tong Williams. Lily was a candidate for the Colorado Libertarian Party in 2014. She's testified against gun control laws, and you can read her article, Guns Against Tyranny. It's published at National Review Online. But Lily is also a very outspoken opponent against Common Core, and I wanted to invite her on the show today because I think her story has a little bit more perspective rather than just parents who are worried about the state taking away their parental rights. She actually grew up in communist China. Lily immigrated here from China in 1988, and she says, as a Chinese immigrant, I know what it means to be free. Now, she has detailed this experience in a very powerful video. It's uploaded to YouTube. It's titled, Common Core is the Communist Core That I Went Through in China. And she wants all parents to just be aware of how Common Core has some striking similarities to the communist education that she experienced growing up in China under Mao's regime. So Lily, thank you so much for joining me today. And I just wanted to get right into it because I think that your story is so important to tell, because we definitely can see that there's a slow creep of tyranny happening here in America. For some, it's so slow that they don't even recognize it, if they even want to believe it's happening at all. But you've lived through it. And that's why I thought your story was just so important. So what was it about Common Core that raised the red flags for you?
Well, I got into more research on Common Core last year when I became the Libertarian candidate for our House District 44 in Colorado. The more research I dig into, the more scared I become. And just based on two principles. One is top-down, centralized government control, nationalized education, nationalized standards, and then that will lead to nationalized assessment and indoctrination, the curriculum. And that's number one. Number two really scares me is that the data tracking collection of our children, and starting as early as kindergarten, preschool, then we'll follow them to college and to the future employment. That's exactly what I went through in China. And that's why I started to come out to say, hey, this just reminds me the China communist education I had under Mao. And I was very scared. I feel like it's my moral obligation to tell people the truth.
Right, and this is something that we actually are hearing. A lot of parents are concerned about these files that are being built on students, that it can obviously follow them throughout their school careers, but also employers might be able to look at these files, and that's exactly what you've experienced. Talk to me a little bit about these files. I know you mentioned that the schools force you to keep a diary where you're basically tattling on your family or friends and anyone that might have a dissident opinion. So talk to me a little bit about that. So if there's any parents out there that are getting some of these, we reported earlier this year about an assignment that students were given. They had to go home and check their medicine cabinet and then write in the assignment what was inside their parents' medicine cabinet. So this is obviously very indicative of these personal diaries that you talk about having to keep.
Well, I was born before Cultural Revolution. So, you know, then I went through entire 10 years Mao's Cultural Revolution in schools. When I started my first grade, and we were chanting every day, required by teachers, like long live Chiang Mai Mao, long live Chinese Communist Party, I love my country. And the teachers want us to write the so-called red diary, which is not private. It's the one that you're supposed to be politically correct and turn them over for teachers' review. In your diary, they want you not to just to talk about your incorrect behaviors, but they do want you to tell them about other people you know, including your neighbors, friends, family members, any incorrect behavior, speeches, even thoughts. We had to do self-criticism about our thoughts on political stuff. We were so young, we didn't understand. So I quickly learned I better not turn in my private diary to teacher. I will turn in the correct one. And this diary, we supposed to encourage you to tell a teacher what's going on in our lives, in our neighborhood. And then we had to quote turn my mouth quotations once a while to show us we are really on the target. And that's really sick because I see that happening in this country where people are encouraged to report on their families and their life and to be politically correct, to conform what the government wants you to do. And neighbors call police, report on each other. It's just really sick. I went through that. I can see clearly what they're doing in this country.
Right. And then with this household registration, and then you have this personnel file, this is then passed along to whatever government corporations people are going to then be kind of funneled through, where you were just one of three people selected to be able to go and work in the law field, right? So if you had messed up, you would have just been sent back to live in poverty.
Yeah, my file followed me since first grade. In this file, my family information, my siblings, and my political beliefs, my family's political class. So they classify people in the red versus black classes, and they know exactly where you live, where your family's from, what do they do, their political beliefs, their religious belief, and if they have any disciplinary actions and my grades, my behaviors, my psychological profile, my mental health. All that details is in my file. We have to take updated picture once a year, and that file follow me to middle school, high school, and college. By the only time I broke that tracking system is by coming to United States. Then they threatened me, you got to sign this piece of paper before you leave. You promise come back to your motherland. All your personal file will be sent back to your hometown in Chengdu, Sichuan province. That means I will lose my professor career in law school in Shanghai forever. I will start fresh when I go back. And also there's always dark shadow there to say I left the country, did not go back on time. It's really that kind of tracking system to keep you under control from birth to death. And that's communist system. I would hate to see that happening in this country.
Right, and it absolutely already is happening in this country. And we already have, they're lauding China for their restrictions on the internet. And again, they're just saying, wow, the Chinese are just doing a really good job there, I guess because they see how high the test scores are. But children are not standardized, but they are forcing them into this standardized form of testing. We actually have a story of an Ohio high school teacher. She won the 2014 Top Teacher Award, and then she resigned at that ceremony, basically saying that she couldn't stand how Common Core was leaving children with special needs behind. And that's exactly what would happen for a student in China. If you're having some issues, you're just going to get, if you can't pass these tests, you're done for.
Yes, so we have a nationalized college entrance exam once a year. That's like really once a lifetime opportunity for you to go to college. And that's the only way you can be enrolled in 4-year government colleges. If you don't pass that, no matter how good student you are, you cannot go. So some students are under tremendous pressure. Sometimes they fail because it's once a time you take that test. And also that this system they have, it's like they just want you to conform. And you spend so much time every day, 10 to 14 hours a day for high school students to prepare for the test. You have no time left for extracurricular activities. You have no time for free mind thinking, for creativity, for innovation. That's why I mentioned in my YouTube video, we have zero Nobel Prize winners from China's education system. United States is ranked number one in the world in terms of Nobel Prize winnings in medicine and in science. That tells you something. So we are a group of huge test takers, machines, but we cannot think independently. We cannot be re-innovative. And that, to me, it tells you something. We should not try to learn and to be like China, because they want their massive students to be like a robot. They are score high in tests, but so what? They have a low life. They have no individual critical thinkings. And when this is America, we want our students to be Americans and who can challenge authorities, who fight for our freedom and not to be controlled by government.
Absolutely. And that is what is so frightening, is that we do see that they are basically training children to be just smart enough to keep pushing all the buttons, to stay right in their little robotic job, to not be able to self-actualize, that we don't need any more inventions or any more innovators, any more ingenuity. And they're de-emphasizing this freedom and the message of the founding fathers and de-emphasizing why they actually fought back against an authoritarian government. They don't want people to embrace that model. And something else that you mentioned, the first step of communism was to take away the parental control of your children and indoctrinate them, because if they can control education and your children, they control the country's future. And that is absolutely frightening, because we do see that happening here. They're taking the parental rights away. You can't even decide what your child can take in at school lunch. They're forced to eat this prison food that they're currently being served in public schools. I mean, just down to that, we see parents can't even walk into a school to pick their child up. They have to wait down in the back of the line, back where the cars are. There was a man that was arrested just trying to go pick his kid up from school. So we're already seeing that. They're telling you children belong to the state. That's quite frightening. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, when I was growing up, our grandparents and parents did not have any parental rights at all. It is clearly the communism declares children belong to the state. They are the state properties. Our parents have no idea. I mean, they have no input, including our teachers have no input. What are you going to learn? How many hours in school and how many days in school? And what kind of a curriculum you will have? We have a nationalized curriculum. Political studies is one of the mandated subjects. And in their political study class, you're supposed to learn communist government version of history. Like today's students I talked to, graduate from college, they don't have idea about what Mao did during Cultural Revolution. They have no idea about the 1989 massacre in Tiananmen Square just 26 years ago, 25 years ago. Because if their parents are not teaching them at home, they are indoctrinated, brainwashed in school. They cannot even know the details about it. It's like a mystery to them. They just pretend nothing happened. That's what I'm afraid in this country. You already say happening in this country, the College Board new framework for AP US history. They do not want you to know about founding fathers and about MLK, about capitalism. So 20 years from now, our kids will be active, productive citizens in this country. And they will not be true Americans anymore, because they have no idea about their past. And they're going to repeat whatever the indoctrination wants them to say and to think. It's a very dangerous trend. That's why I'm so scared. That's why I am fighting this. This education issue is very dear to my heart. I think if you let your federal government, private corporation in bed together, control our education, take away our parental bill of rights, then we will not be the same country 20 years from now on.
Right. America is, you know, that you mentioned that the Bill of Rights and the Declaration of Independence were the two documents that made you come to America versus going to France or Spain or some other country. Those two documents are what they're trying to de-emphasize and take away the power of the people. And of course, America, as the land of the free, this shining beacon in the darkness, if we fall into tyranny, then the whole world will go. So, I mean, this is a very important thing for people to listen to your story. You lived through it. You can see the writing on the wall. And, I mean, do we think, is there enough time to turn this back around? Are the children already so indoctrinated? We had a Mark Dice video where they didn't even know who MLK was. They did not even know who Martin Luther King Jr. was. They thought he had just passed away, you know, that week when we were celebrating his birthday. So, I mean, are we too far?
Well, I am still trying to be optimistic because I believe that this is a country of the free and home of the brave. But I'm calling on all brave Americans to get involved, to take action. If you majority of American people is silent when government's doing this kind of garbage to our country, to our children, then you're going to lose all the rights of freedom you have. So I'm still fighting. I want the people to join the fight and speak out and spread my messages, and by somebody who lived through this tyranny, this communist core education. If we all united, do not give up and keep fighting, yelling, screaming, and shouting, we will hold our elected politicians accountable. We just cannot be silent. We cannot just say, oh, there's nothing as an individual I can do. I too believe in individualism. One individual can make big difference. If we have millions of them united to make difference, the impact will be huge. So we just have to send a very clear loud message to those people in Washington, in your state board of education, in your state house and Senate, and ask them to listen to you, to keep our freedom, to fight for parental bill of rights, and to keep our children belong to their parents, not to the state. But that will be going down the communist path. So please ask people to listen to this and go to my Facebook page, follow my post, and let's fight this together. Time is running out. We got to take action every day.
Absolutely. Very well said. And just briefly, now I know that something else that was really important to you, gun control laws. You are very outspoken against that. You have an article called Guns Against Tyranny published on National Review Online. Just briefly talk to me about that article and why, in your experience, is this important?
I just testified a couple of weeks ago to support a bill to repeal magazine ban in Colorado. They want to limit our magazines to be 15 rounds. And I asked them this question, how am I going to use it against tyranny? Do you limit your government soldiers' magazines? Do criminals limit theirs? No. You only want to limit ours. Then how am I going to go fight against tyranny like students, citizens in Beijing 1989? If the government had all the tanks, all the machine guns, and citizens had no guns at all, you know, gun rights is extremely dear to me. When I first come to this country, hold a gun in my hand, I feel first time in my life, I'm no longer a slave. So I want to tell people gun rights, education are the two biggest issues we are facing today. Hold on to those rights and fight with your life, with your last breath. Do not give them up. And they are going to lose their children. They are going to lose their Second Amendment right if they don't fight really hard to speak up. And I'm not exaggerating. It's like making things up or, calling this communist core. To me, ET is true. You know, I went through that. I can see their strategy, their tactics are so familiar to me. It's like, don't bully me. I have listened to that before. I have seen that. Right. I don't buy that at all. They make sounds wonderful. Global ready, college ready. We are new world order. You know, we're going to improve our standards. It's BS. It's not their purpose. Their purpose is to have government control. It's for profit.
Yeah, absolutely.
Made for the corporations.
Yeah, and you know, for Americans, we've just always been free, quote unquote free. So we don't even realize when our liberties are being taken away from us, just slowly but surely. But from someone who's come where you had absolutely zero freedom to a country that is free, you know, you're able to just recognize when those liberties are being slowly pulled and you know what tyranny looks like, so
that's their technique anyway. Their technique is to take away, like Hitler said, just take away their freedom a little by little every day, so they don't realize it until the points cross. It's too late, you know. You will be too late. I think this next couple years is very critical for us to fight, get rid of Common Core, and get rid of gun control attempts by some people. And to get people to involve, to be educated. There are lots of Americans who just not educated, they're not informed. And how important it is for you to keep your freedom. I think that's the most important thing in your life, because that's for your children's, grandchildren's sake. It's not just for your lifetime anymore. Right. So you cannot just go to work, bring home the bacon, make the money. I understand to some people that's priority if they're just making the ends meet. But if you let the government to take more and more your freedom, you cannot become successful. You cannot be prosperous. No matter how much you make, you're going to turn over to most of your earnings to Uncle Sam. What good does that do if you make more money?
Yeah, and you lived through food rationing, so you know what that's like, being taken care of by the government, providing for all of your needs when you live in a house that didn't even have heat or running water and, you know, food rationing. So I don't know why people think that they're just going to be living in luxury when the state takes care of them. They're calling
the
state
mommy and daddy. Yeah, that's what central planning socialism do to you, that eventually people who are productive, they have no incentives to go invest to produce jobs. And just like a movie, Agnes Schrock, you know, all those productive people will be disappearing. You know, that's what the China economy was when I was growing up. It was no productivity. It was not efficient. So people were dirt poor. Everybody was poor except maybe very few percentage on the top. You know, then we had like a little bit food, meat, and just rice and to survive. Right. You know, I really, that's why I can't let my kids waste food in this country. It's like, even though what I went through, you got to eat this leftover next day.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing that I find so surprising is that we have so many Americans that take their liberty for granted. And then we do have people that come here and are fighting for our freedoms because, of the, you know, they're fighting for the freedoms that they came here to enjoy as well. It's just, I mean, it's pretty crazy to me that you have a lot of, you know, kids growing up now that don't even know the story of the Founding Fathers or don't can't even say any bits of the Declaration of Independence. But, you know, we're happy to have you on our side.
I'm glad too. I want all liberty loving people in this country really to be united. I want to point out another communist tactic is to divide the people, divide their citizens by classify them, by politically categorize them, you know, white versus black and brown. And I don't fight that because I want all people who love freedom to realize that's typical government strategy. They want you to be divided. They want the laborers to report on each other. They even want families to report on each other. Guess yeah. what? They benefit. That means they got you totally controlled. When you are not loyal to each other anymore, you become more loyal to the, you know, the government regime, and you put, you know, call police every time you got an issue with your neighbor. It's wrong. It's dangerous. That's yeah. what we went through in China. So don't let the government divide us. We need to be united, and we need to be more tolerant of each other.
Yeah, absolutely. Goodness, you're like giving me the goosebumps because that's what we are seeing here with the nanny state and people calling on their neighbors and tattling and forcing families to be broken up and divided. A mom had to go to jail because she dared let her child play at the playground while she was working, even though she could see her, you know, out the window. And I mean, that's the kind of thing that's happening now. It's just it's just crazy to actually listen to what you're saying and to, you know, for what we do here at InfoWars, it's just the writing
that's
is on the wall.
That's why I posted something on Valentine's Day that we could not even tell our families about love. We're supposed to express love to the party, to the chairman Mao. And they think that when you love each other as individuals, then they cannot regulate. That's very private. That's expression of individualism. And they want you to be totally loyal to them, to love them. That's why you, when you see communist countries, they always have pretty girls, pretty boys, young pictures, and to show their total loyalty to the party, to the political regime. That's a very, very sick society. I still have a hard time to tell my family today in China, I love you in Chinese, because we were criticized that time if you do that. So they're not used to it. But I tell my kids in this country all the time, I love you in both Chinese and English. I have no problem. But I can't do that to my own family members in China. Is that sick? And that's why some immigrants are not standing up, speaking up like me, because they are still trapped in their indoctrinated mind, in their old mentality. Some are afraid. They cannot, you know, conquer that fear, their government might still give them the retaliation. I keep telling myself, well, this is my duty. I cannot live in fear. I'm going to say whatever I believe is true.
Well, Lily, thank you so much for joining us today. Lily for Liberty, that's your Facebook page. Be sure to go there, like her page. She's updating constantly every day, a lot of calls to action. I know people are always looking for solutions. You know, how can we actually do anything about this tyranny? And you do provide a lot of those things there, just very simple steps that people can do one person at a time. Yes, an individual can make a difference. Lilyforliberty.com. Thank you so much.
Thank you.